Good morning, guys. It's about 7:15 in the morning, and we are headed out on the road. So it's sayonara to the shed project for now, and I hope to be bringing you some good footage and good pictures of all kinds of great scenery. But our first stop is going to be the Badlands and Black Hills, Mount Rushmore, that whole area in South Dakota. We'll stay there tonight and tomorrow night, and then from there we'll head towards Colorado. So hope you guys enjoy the trip as much as I think I'm gonna, hope I'm gonna, and let's get on the road. Hey everybody, we are entering South Dakota here in a couple minutes. I actually think we've technically crossed the border, we just haven't seen the sign yet, because this exit here is South Dakota exit. So I think we're in South Dakota. Big Sioux Recreation Area. Yeah, we definitely gotta be in South Dakota. So I'll let you guys get a view of what we're looking at. I've got my phone on Facebook live streaming right now. So we're filming two different ways here. Not a whole lot to see right now, but in about 400 miles we'll see some interesting stuff. Hopefully it's not pouring rain when we get out there. I haven't checked the weather today yet, but that's what I'm hoping anyways. This is it. This is our exit for the Badlands, so I'm not sure how much further we got until we actually start getting into them, but I can see them, or a little bit of them anyways, but I don't know how far in we have to go before we're actually in them. But I'll give some more video when we get closer. This is exit 131. On I-90 in South Dakota, and this is known as the scenic loop for the Badlands. So here we go. I don't know if you can see them off in the distance there. Thank you. We're out here at the Badlands, and this is our first kind of scenic overlook. And I'm blown away. I've never seen anything like this other than in pictures, so I don't even know what to say other than wow. It's crazy. But I'll go ahead and finish walking out this way and show you just exactly what we're looking at.
Right. I can delete pictures.
Then we have a little quimpy face. Yeah.
Just out here scratching an itch. Getting rid of all that winter fur. Guys, we made it. We made it to the Sage Creek campground, and I've hiked to the top of, I'm not going to call it a mountain, but it's definitely a big hill. I guess I don't know if they consider this the Black Hills, probably, but I can see the Badlands over it. I guess that would be the south. There, I'll spin it around for you. So the Badlands are over that way. You probably can't tell in the video, but, and the campground is that little area right there. There's 20 sites. It's a free campground. Cedar Creek campground is what it's called. And I got one of the last two spots, so pretty stoked about that. But I'm sleeping in the back of my truck anyways, or SUV. It's not really a truck, but it's got a hitch, so it's a truck to me. It's a pretty beautiful country out here. I gotta thank my wife for putting up with me. Putting up with the tractors, putting up with all the other nonsense, and letting me come out here and do this, because, I don't know, I guess, you know, my dad died at an early age because of a heart attack, and it was led on by his life choices, you know, drugs, alcohol, all that stuff. But it ended up, you know, doing a lot of damage to his heart, and he ended up suffering a heart attack at the age of 55. And he made a lot of bad decisions health-wise, and it caught up with him. But that weight kind of shuffled onto my shoulders. So now here I am, 34 years old, and I always feel rushed, you know. I feel like if I don't do things, then I'm not going to get to see it. You know, stuff like this, the Badlands and Colorado and just all kinds of stuff. I want to see, you know, Glacier National Park. I want to see the Redwood Forest. I want to see the Grand Canyon. I want to see all that beautiful, beautiful stuff that this country that we're lucky enough to call home has to offer. And sometimes it's just a lot to bear that weight on your shoulders. It's, you know, you try not to think about it, because, you know, you got to put your faith in the man upstairs, and hopefully he blesses you with a long and happy life. But you just never know. And I don't know how much longer I want to stand on this hilltop, because there's rain coming in, and he might just call me home early, if you know what I'm saying. But beautiful country. It's incredible. And I can see way off in the distance, you guys probably can't see it, but the sunlight is just barely dancing off some of the Badlands over there. But rain's starting to come down now, so I'm gonna make my way down this hill and hunker down in the truck before I get too soaking wet. So This campground is awesome, by the way. They've got prairie dogs running all over the place. And the buffalo, or bison, whatever, I'm not sure what the difference is, but they're scattered about all over, and there was one walking right through the middle of the campsite, scratching himself on all the picnic tables and everything else. They're getting rid of their winter fur, so. Anyways, I'm gonna make my way down before I get struck by lightning, and we'll see you guys tomorrow. Take care. Well, good morning, guys. We survived the night in the truck and got down to about 37, 38 degrees, so it was a little cold, but we made it work. Just chilling here with the buffalo. It was scratching itself on the parking posts out here, but now he's just staring into the sunrise, probably wondering what the heck I'm doing. So I'm going to get some breakfast. All I got is sandwich stuff and apples and oranges, but that'll do. So make a couple sandwiches and go from there. All right, see you guys on the ride. Mm-hmm.